Hi, and welcome to part two. In part two of my Forex training series, I'm going to introduce you to one of the most important ideas you can learn as a Forex trader. In case you did not watch the previous steps, this is a free Forex training series on what you need to learn in order to win. Now, this next idea is one that got me hooked all those years ago. What do we do as Forex traders? I mean, in a nutshell, how would you describe what we do? I'll tell you. We speculate on future price movement. That's what we do. Will price go up or will price go down? How far is it likely to move? If you can identify which way price is likely to go, you have a blank check. So the next question is this: how do we do it? To answer this, we need a simple lesson in logic. Most of us understand logic in a basic way, and all of us use logic every day without even thinking about it. Logic can be defined as information that forms into an argument. In Forex trading, an argument for whether price is likely to move up or down, for example. The source and core of that information comes back to one thing: human behavior, repetitive human behavior. The source of logic is repetitive human behavior. You avoid rush hour traffic using this principle. Grocery stores decide what to charge you using this principle, and you can anticipate what price is likely to do using this principle. If you want to know what people are likely to do, you must know what they are doing now and what they've done in the past. Human beings are creatures of habit. Think about how easy it is for you to predict what a good friend might do or say in a particular situation. Forex trading is no different. Those charts you see, that price moving up and down, those are buyers and sellers. Those buyers and sellers are human beings. So we could call what we see on the charts candle or chart patterns, but what they really are human behavior patterns. In this Forex training series, I'm going to show you human behavior patterns that repeat with as much as 90% regularity. This is important because if you base your decisions on behavior that repeats with great regularity, not only do you understand how it works, you develop confidence in what you're doing. To give you a specific example, this is the most reliable behavior pattern in Forex trading. Notice price moving down, pull back, and then push down again. There is no pattern which repeats with greater regularity that you can rely on. I'll be covering that in great detail in later parts, but I wanted to give you a specific example of human behavior that repeats in Forex trading. There is much more. Now you might ask at some point, Vance, why are you doing this? Why are you giving away knowledge? It's simple. Knowing something is different from being able to do something. Imagine that you read 1,000 books on hitting a baseball, but you've never hit one. You could talk with great intelligence, and what you say could be quite valuable, but you really can't do it yourself, and therein lies the difference. Using that same baseball analogy, I'm the coach. The value of the coach is that he can see what you're doing well and what you're doing poorly. And this can save you years of trial and error. If you ever want to learn more, watch my special video. You'll see me trade, hear from other traders, and hear about a free trial offer. Coming up in part three, I'm going to teach you about the language we use as traders. I don't think there's a lot of terms that we use that are unique, but it is important that you understand what we do use. If you aren't ready for the special video yet, proceed to part three, where I'll explain the terms we use as Forex traders and what you need to know. I'll see you there.